Before we start to look at fdisk, I want to show where we see the labels that we updated in the last video. I've got a GUI file manager window open, and I'm plugging in the USB drive that we updated in the last video. And here we see the four different partition labels. We see we've got partition 1 being the fat partition 2 being the ext4 partition, and so on. Okay, on to fdisk. I'm switching to the command line window, and we need to have root privileges to use the fdisk command, so I will have to type sudo before typing the fdisk command. Sudo fdisk-l. And fdisk lists the disk information about all the disks it finds on this computer. Most of the time, this is more information than we need, and we want to just see information about a single drive. I'm going to clear the screen and arrow up to bring back that fdisk command again and add on /dev/sdb. And now we only see information about the SDB drive, and the output is very similar to what we saw with the parted print commands. We can see that the disk label type is MS-DOS, or just DOS as it is shown here. And then we see the four partitions that we created in the last video. To get into fdisk command mode, I'm going to arrow up to bring back that last command, and I'm going to remove that dash L. And now instead of listing out the dev SDB drive, I will be in fdisk command mode for the dev SDB drive. We're getting a message that the disk is currently in use. We want to unmount the SDB partitions before we start to work with it. So I will quit out of this by typing Q. We're out of fdisk, and I will unmount the four partitions with umount/dev sdb1, sdb2, sdb3, and sdb4. And let's go back into fdisk with sudo fdisk dev sdb. And now we get the standard welcome to fdisk message, and it's telling us that we need to write out the changes before we exit fdisk, or our changes will not be made. And then we see the fdisk prompt asking us what fdisk command we want to run, and it's telling us we can type M for help. So I will type M. We see a lot of information here. I'm not going to go through every single one of these, but we'll look at enough to get us familiar with fdisk. Under the MISC heading, we see M is used to print this menu. So M is for menu. I want to see what is currently on this USB drive, and to do that, I will type P for print the partition table. And we see the same output that we saw when we typed fdisk-l/dev/sdb. We've got four partitions, and I want to delete them using fdisk. I'm going to scroll up a bit, and here under generic, I see D, delete a partition. So I will type D. It's asking me what partition I want to delete. I'll delete partition 1. And then I will press D again. This time I'll delete partition number 3. Oh, and let's take a look at what that looks like. I'm going to press P. And now we see that we only have partitions 2 and 4. I'll delete partition number 2. And now when I press D, it doesn't ask us what partition because there's only one there. It deletes it. I'll type P again to take a look at our partition table. And we see there are no partitions, and we have a disk label type of DOS. I want to change this partition table to a GPT disk partition table. I'm going to type M again. And here at the bottom, we see create a new label. And under that, we see G, create a new empty GPT partition table. I will type the lowercase g and then enter. And we get a warning that this device contains a DOS signature and it will be removed. Most of the time, that's what we're going to want to do, to wipe the signatures when relabeling to avoid possible collisions. I will now type W to write out the changes, and those changes were to remove the four partitions and then to make this a GPT disk partition table. Now, instead of W, if I type Q right now, I would quit out without writing, so those four partitions would still remain as they were, and the disk partition table would stay as DOS because we have not written anything out yet. I want to write out those changes, so I am going to use W and press Enter. Fdisk makes our changes and returns me to the regular command line. I'll go back into Fdisk for the SDB drive by pressing the arrow up and then Enter. And now I'll press P to print the disk information. We see that we currently have no partitions, and our disk partition table has been updated to GPT. Now I want to add a new disk partition to this disk. To do that, I'll type N for new. And it's asking me what partition number I want to give it. Numbers 1 through 128, I will type 1. And now it's asking for the first sector, meaning where do we want the starting point of this partition to be? It can be a number greater than or equal to 2048, but it must be less than 3915742. The default is that lowest number 2048, so I will press Enter, making our starting sector 2048. Now Fdisk is asking us for the last sector of the partition, meaning how big do we want this partition? If we want one single partition to take the entire disk, we could type 3915742, or we could just press Enter, and Fdisk will assume we want to make this a single partition taking up all the free space available. I want this partition to be 1 gigabyte, so I will type plus 1G, meaning add 1 gigabyte from the starting point of this partition. Fdisk is telling me it created a new Linux file system partition, but this partition has a signature of VFAT. Do I want to remove that? I'm going to type N for no, because I want to make this a FAT file system. So how do I change my partition type? I'm going to type M to bring up that menu. And under generic, we see T, change a partition type. Typing T, we get the question, what partition type do we want to make this? And we can type L to list all. I'll type L. And here we see a big list. I can scroll down and up using my arrow keys. I want to make this an MS-DOS partition. And we see the numbers 10 through 14 are all Microsoft Windows partition types. Which one should I choose? Well, we talked about this in a previous video. The partition type doesn't really make that big of a difference. It's the file system that we put on that partition that makes the difference. Just the same, I want to make this partition show as a Microsoft partition. So I'm going to choose number 11, Microsoft Basic Data. I'm going to press Q to quit out of the partition type listing. And then I'll type 11 for the Microsoft Basic Data. And my partition type has been updated. Now I want to make a second new partition. So again, I'll type N. I'll make this partition number 2. And now it's showing me the first free sector as 2099200, the default. So I will press Enter to have that be the starting position. And the ending position, I'm going to press Enter for the default of 3915742. That's that same number we saw earlier. And our partition 2 type Linux file system has been created. And if we want to see what number the Linux file system is, I can type L to list the file types. And we see here that number 20 is the Linux file system. I'm typing Q to go back. And I'm going to type P to look at what we're going to make this drive. We see the two partitions. The first one is a Microsoft Basic Data, and the second one is a Linux file system. I want to write these changes out, so I'm going to type W. And fdisk makes those changes and puts me back into a regular Linux command prompt. Now I still need to make my file systems for the two partitions that we just created. I will make my first file system a FAT32 with the command sudo mkfs make file system dot fat. And we're going to make this a -f32. And we want to put this on /dev/sdb1. And now let's make our ext4 file system with the command sudo mkfs make file system ext4. And also for the dev sdb, but this time we want it for partition number 2. Let's check everything to make sure it all looks good with the command lsblk-o, and I want to see the name, label, size, fs type, fs version, for device, sdb. And here we see we created a 1 gigabyte partition that has a FAT32 file system and a second partition that is less than a gigabyte but is formatted with the ext4 partition. There's also a command out there called cfdisk. Let's run that right now with sudo cfdisk /dev/sdb. This might be a little easier to work with for some. It's the same fdisk command, only with a nicer format. The C is because it's a cursus-based program. We will still have to write out our changes before we exit, or those changes will not be made, just like the regular fdisk command. I'll quit out of here by pressing enter. In the next video, we'll continue looking at the Linux command line.